My name is Natasha McBride, and I suffer from cyberbullying. I was bullied on a website called Fornspring. An unknown writer wrote, "You think you are pretty and all the girls love you? It's called acting. Start acting nicer to people or you will lose everyone. Mark my words." I replied by saying, "Who are you?" That comment really struck my heart. After reading that comment, I searched online for the easiest way to die. I love the song Grenade by Bruno Mars, and especially the lyrics, "I jump in a furniture chain for you." On February 13th, I had another Facebook disagreement with some bullies. Also, I received a text from a boy that I like, saying that we should just be friends. The next day, I jumped in front of a train near my house and died immediately. I died on Valentine's Day.
My name is Megan Meyer. I am a victim of cyberbullying. I died believing that somewhere in this world lived a boy by the name of Josh Evans. He spoke for several weeks, but only through MySpace. He claimed to have recently moved near my house, but was homeschooled and did not yet have a phone number. I never saw him in person, but that didn't matter at the time. I was in love. On October 15, 2003, everything changed. He began to call me names and insulted me. The last thing he wrote was, "The world would be a better place without you." I ran into my closet because I didn't know what to do or how to defend myself. I felt alone, hopeless, and as if I had no one to go to. My mother discovered my body hanging in my bedroom closet. I was only 13 years old. 6 weeks after my death, my parents learned that Josh Evans never existed. He was an online character created by my mother's friend, 47-year-old Lori Drew, who lived four houses down my block.
My name is Phoebe Prince, and I suffer from bullying and rape. I recently moved to Massachusetts from Ireland. I suffered 3 long months of name-calling and vicious abuse online. Throughout these 3 months, I faced abusive threats on Facebook and text messages, got things thrown at me, and pictures of myself scribbled. I faced these threats and bullying because I was dating the senior football player. My aunt and I tried to go to school officials, but nothing was done. I've been called many names such as slut and Irish whore. The day before I took my life, I said school has been intolerable. The day I killed myself, one of the bullies, Ashley Lange, threw a drink at me in a car. That was the last straw for me. On the same day, I hung myself on the staircase of my house, and my little sister was the one who found me.
My name is Ryan Halligan, and I was a victim of cyberbullying. I was bullied since 5th grade. I told my father. My father only told me that it was just words and to move on from it. The bullying continued. I thought that the person who was bullying me was actually becoming friends with me, but I was betrayed. He spread a rumor online and in school that I was gay. People who didn't usually bully me began to. They thought it was fun. I began to get vulgar, homophobic emails. I didn't tell my parents. I began long online chats with a girl that I liked, but it was all a joke. The girl told me, "You're just a loser. I don't want anything to do with you." I was just joking in front of her friends. I felt humiliated. I told her, "It's girls like you that made me want to kill myself." I was emotionally battered and had undiagnosed depression. I died a month later. I hung myself in the bathroom of my home.
My name is Jamie Rodemar, and I have been a victim of cyberbullying. I had just begun my freshman year at Williamsville North High School, and this is where I began to be harassed by online students. I posted messages on YouTube for a project called It Gets Better, a support group for gay lesbian youth where I recorded my struggles. I was gay, and other students would taunt me, call me a faggot in the hallways. I thought that I could never escape it. I was also bullied online through my Fornspring account, where students used slurs toward me for more than a year. Someone on the internet posted, "You weren't born this way. You shouldn't have had been born at all." Another posted, "I wouldn't care if you died. No one would. So just do it. It would make everyone happier." I became overwhelmed by all the taunting. I endured and posted my farewell on one of my blogs online before I killed myself. I was 14 years old. When I committed suicide, I was found dead outside my home on September 18th, 2011.
Over 25% of adolescents and teens have been bullied repeatedly through their cell phones or the internet.
62% said they have been cyberbullied by another student in school.
58% have not told their parents or an adult about something mean or hurtful that happened to them online.
53% of kids admit having said something mean or hurtful to another person online.
22% of kids have been bullied while online. 1 in 4 have had it and happened more than once.
46% of kids have been cyberbullied by a friend.
35% of kids have been threatened online.
Stop cyberbullying.
Chance for you, 'cause there's a spark in you.